I'm going to show you the different strategies with how to play solo versus live. Sup y'all, have you checked out Loot Crate yet? This is one of my favorite websites. I know I've gotten a Loot Crate many, many times. I get it as a subscription. Sometimes I get it for my birthday, year by year. This is an amazing site. If you haven't heard it before, it's basically all of these cool sci-fi, anime, different types of things you could get. Here, look, check out some of the crates. Then I know they got apparel and all that. I personally prioritize the crates, and my first Loot Crate I ever got was Deadpool. If you're a big Marvel fan, this is the first one I ever got. It's really amazing. You get different types of merchandise, flip-flops come in the crate, and again, this is a month-to-month subscription. You can change it. You can do anything you want. You can pick the different crates here. Look, check it out. You can even pick anime, different types of Marvel characters, and they all come with different like Funko Pops, shirts. I cannot express how much I love Loot Crate. Definitely click my affiliate link below. That'll help my channel grow. I get a small commission from that. But other than that, I love this. When you're playing solo, you're just playing by yourself for fun, trying to get to a high round. Like, I think in Sunny Meadow, I'm in 2000, I'm like in 200 and something. Lost Desert right now, I'm only in round, 120. You're just trying to make it to the next round, the next round, the next round, over and over and over and over. And I got all these hacks and different cheats, so definitely check out those videos at the end. But the purpose of solo is just try to make it to the next round. Now, the purpose of live, if someone's hosting and you're playing against, 50 other people, it's not, or 100 other people, 1,000, whatever you want to call it. The method is not necessarily the same. You're not necessarily worried about life, okay? So let's go over the solo strategies first. I'm going to show you how to play Tower Defense live versus solo. So right now, this is my solo map on the Lost Desert, and as you can see, I'm kind of just like mad glitching the evil blooks right here, the dark slime and the white slime right here in this area with my party pigs. And this is the same strategy that you would use in Sunny Meadow. You want to trap them here. So I made a whole mess of videos, like at least 10 set of videos of that. Okay, and I think most people know that this is the strategy, trying to trap them with the party pigs, the wind dragon, maybe even the owl, not the owl, maybe even the penguin early on. And I think people know to buff them up with the gesture. Okay, that's solo. The reason why you have to do that, I think a lot of people haven't been explaining this, is because your life matters here, right here. This life bar, if that dark slime somehow makes it all the way through the end, you're dead, y'all. You're dead. Okay, so basically what you're trying to do is trap them within this little S shape, and this goes with Sunny Meadow and also the Lost Desert. You trap them here either indefinitely with, party pigs or wind dragons, because you're worried about these slimes going all the way to the end. So these party pigs are only dealing what, like 5 damage, okay? Like nothing essentially, right? And then these mini jesters are dealing no damage. Now I know they're buffing the other towers that are, but because these aren't dealing damage, because I'm purely using them as a support blook, like I buffed them in a way, I boosted them in a way that wasn't focusing on damage, but more of like area effect to do this dance and things like that. It's not doing too much damage, but I don't care, because the point is not to deal damage as much as it is not to, lose my life. That's the biggest thing between solo and live. Let's go to the live strategies. So I just hosted a game right now. I'm playing quote unquote live. And normally under these circumstances, I would be prioritizing, unicorns and owls, and not owls, my gosh, again, penguins, maybe even owls too, to like put some, get some high firepower. But in this situation, if you notice up here, life doesn't matter. Like in the other situation, I was worried about the dark slime and the white slime and all the other evil blooks going over here and my life, dramatically going down. In this situation, I'm not worried so much about that yet. Okay, I'm not saying it's not a priority. I'm saying in general, you should focus on firing rate. So I'm just gonna boost up the firing rate right there. And as you can see, I'm getting coins for each time I, put damage down. So I'm just gonna show you in a second what happens, okay? So check it out. Again, this is live. If you're playing with like 50 other people, 1,000 other people, I'm not gonna add another tower. I just want you to see something, okay? So check it out. So I'm putting, firing rate down. Okay, the chick is generally like handling it. You can kind of see, okay, the chick can do that, right? So let's continue. And this is really important part of also playing live. There are all these weird power-ups, okay? Getting an extra tower, Earthquake, which is miserable, right? Earthquake puts all your towers in a different position. Crazy are the ducks, okay? The tax time. Live is nuts. And because of that, because of all those boosts and especially the earthquake, if you start buying, this is initially, okay? This is just a strategy to think about. Initially, if you start buying these more expensive blooks, if towers, these good blooks, these towers right here, you buy expensive ones, and it gets earthquake, well, now they're all over the place. So now you just spent all this money and you might not have enough to like move it around and buy something else. So which is why you should prioritize on cheaper towers first, especially in the case of an earthquake, right? I'm just gonna keep on clicking next round so you can kind of see. So as you can see, it's kind of going through. So look what happens here, okay? Round three, already the chick is not gonna be enough. I'm just already showing you what's happening, okay? So look, these are all points lost, by the way. Now, are you noticing this? Look. Even though those blooks, those evil blooks went through, my stars didn't go down. This is the main difference. In solo, when you're playing solo, if those evil blooks went through, you would have died. You probably would have went to, probably life went down to 50 or something. But the point is, it would have been miserable, right? You're like, oh my gosh, don't let them go through. You're like freaking out, right? So it doesn't matter as much if they go through. What does matter is that you hit them with damage. Plus, this is another bonus here. Do you want to take a risk? Man, there's another thing. Like, if you're playing live, if you click yes, something good might happen, or something bad. You click no, then you don't know, right? So this is another thing of playing live. There's other factors. There's chance. There's the earthquakes. There's all these weird things that happen, which is why it's so important that you prioritize cheaper blooks at first that have firing rate to get damage down, because the point is damage. Damage, 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 damage. So I'm just going to click yes, for example. Oh, see, I double my damage. Great. Like I said, it doesn't matter if they go through. And do firing rate again, focusing on high firing rate, high firing rate, high firing rate, times three, damage. And then now I have some extra coins here, right? So I want to put squirrels down. And again, I'm not going to get too into, you know, blooke placement right now, but just talking about firing rate, okay? That's exactly what you need is firing rate. Oh, see, annoying duck. See, this is another one here. See, this could really mess up your whole board and whole strategy. And you can't really, you know, plan for that when you're playing live with everyone else. So firing rate and then a transform. Check it out. So let's look here. So I'm putting like damage down fast, 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 fast. And because I'm going really, 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 really fast, okay, I'm gonna get to the next round quicker. Because what happens here is that if some of these blooks pass this point here, right, if they pass this point here, you have to wait to the next round. Well, so while your friend has put down all this damage, you have to wait to the next round, which is miserable. Okay, so check it out. Initially, like I said, focus on firing rate. Okay, firing rate and cheaper blooks, and that is the biggest difference between live and solo. I really hope this helps you, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I'll check you later.